Here's where the wires come in. Now here's a piece of metal. I've got the continuity tester on. It makes sense that if I'm touching one piece of metal with the two probes, whether it's the little short one on the left or the long one on the right, that's continuity. Now you can see there I'm getting continuity between the short piece and that long piece I'm now touching. What I discovered earlier when I touched way out there to the right, I was not getting continuity. It was acting as if it wasn't connected. And that makes no sense. Well, it finally made sense that this little contact underneath here must have gone bad. So let me file that with my nail file. And that was the only problem. That's all it was. That switch has moved whenever you open the door. So from repeating that, opening the door, and that little spark, that made things wear out so it no longer have conductivity. So I'll chase the mechanism down here. And with some little thermal looking thing down there. Now let's go take a look at that. I've just turned on the toaster. This piece in here, you see two screw heads adjusting two different things. Look at the right hand one pointing at a little silver circle. Now, it takes a few minutes, but then that apparently triggers the circuit so that whatever this long thing is inside that metal sleeve, it is now flexing ever so slowly toward this little screw head. And when it touches, that's when we get the bell. The arc can cross there, complete the circuit, and it's the solenoid that rings the bell and breaks the circuit. Let's see that little zap there in slow motion. Ooh. It is now armed and heating up. Let's watch that again. So as that little arm approaches, we go take a look at the shaft of the solenoid. Fires to the right very fast, so let's slow that down. It fires to the right. You can barely even perceive it.